Hello and welcome to today's episode of Ask Raghav. I hope all of you are doing awesome. Today I'm going to take up a very general question that will be relevant to each and every one of you, whether you are working into automation testing or you are into development or you are working with any tool or any technology, it will be very relevant to you. So let's start today's episode of Ask Raghav. Whenever you are working with automation frameworks or into development or any tool or any technology, a lot of times we face issues and we go to Google and search for the issues. Now, I do get these kind of questions every day. I get a lot of these questions. Now, sometimes I do know the solutions directly and I tell you that, but a lot of times I go online and I search for the issue and then I find some resources and links which have the exact solution and then I share the links. I was thinking that it is not a difficult process, it is a very easy process. What if each one of us knows that and then you can troubleshoot your issues very quickly on your own and you may not require a lot of external help. So today let me show you how exactly you can find solutions to your problems. So I will go to my system and let me go here. So here is a comment. So here you can see the comment. It is from Kumari Raina. This is the comment I received today. And she says, I'm getting error while creating pom.xml file. And the error is failed to read artifact descriptor for io.cucumber, cucumber java jar. Now see, if I just go and copy this error statement or the problem statement and I go to Google and I will just copy the complete problem statement here. So let me just go here and paste it here. Now if you see here, you may get some solutions, but because I have given a very specific part of the problem, that is io.cucumber.cucumber java 6.9.1, so it may happen that I may not get very good results from here. It will happen a lot of times when you give your complete problem statement, you will get the direct solutions and the best solutions within the first few links, but sometimes you may not get a direct solution. In that case, what you can do is, you can see this is a generic part until here, failed to read the artifact descriptor, and for cucumber and particular jar file I am going to remove this. So now I am keeping only the general part and I will now search. And you can now see the first link now I have got is from Stack Overflow. And if I go and check, I will open this link. And here you can see, this is a very general and common question. It has been asked and upvoted by 272 people as of this time. And you can see here, this is the general problem statement, failed to read artifact descriptor. Now you can go down and if you see the solution, you can again see there is a, this is the best solution which is accepted by 192 people. And here you just have to run this command and then you can also use the minus u option to force to check for updated releases. And you can also read all these comments here. Now it may also happen that the best solution as of here may not be useful to you, but some solution here, if you scroll down, can help you. Now here you can see we have so many other solutions, and here is a solution for IntelliJ IDEA. And then if you scroll down, you can see a solution for Eclipse. And if I see the video, this is on my Selenium Cucumber Java project, which I created on Eclipse. So the user can directly do this on Eclipse, that is go to project, right click Maven update project, and this will be resolved. And you can see all these options are here. And if you see my answer here, so you can see my answer, I have given the first option for Eclipse, which was not the first option here, but because I know that the user is using Eclipse as per my video, so I have given the first option to update Maven from Eclipse. Then this is the second option again from Eclipse. Then this is the third option to update the Maven dependency, and then finally the Maven command. So if you see here, a lot of times it will happen that you copy your complete problem statement as it is on Google and you will find the solution. But it may also happen a lot of times that you have to only take out the general part and then search for the solution, and you will get very good solutions online. Let me also show you one other comment here. This is again a comment I got today. And here again you can see this is from Anurag. And Anurag says, Getting the below error, Java lang security exception, class org hamcrest dot matches. Now again, if you look at my answer, this again comes from an online link, and again let us see how to search for the solution. I will just copy here the problem statement until here, and let me go back again to Google, and you can see here I have got a Stack Overflow resources here, and let me again just keep it until here and check again, and you can see this is the best solution I can think of, or this I believe will be the best solution. And again you can see here on this link, if I go to the general solution, and somebody has given a proper link for this solution, and here the solution which has helped most of the people is the hamcrest jar needs to go before the JUnit library in the build path, and you can see some comments as well here. And then if I scroll down, you can again see different solutions that has helped. If I go and see my solution that I have given, I have also told Anurag to keep the hamcrest jar file before JUnit library, and I have also given the link for this resource of Stack Overflow. So this will help the user in case the solution which I have provided may not help him directly. I have given the link and he can look at all the other possible solutions. So now you can see and understand, whenever you have any issue, you just get the problem statement. And sometimes if you have something general and you do not know, you do not have a log, or you do not have an actual documented problem statement, still you can go to Google and you can search for whatever is the problem you are facing. For example, not able to update Python on Mac. You can just go and search on Google and you will get so many solutions. So I hope next time you have a problem, you will follow these steps and you can now troubleshoot easily and you can find the solutions. Now don't worry, I'm not saying that you should not send me your problems. You can always send me if you are not able to find anything online, and I'm always here to help you. And I will see you in the next episode. Do take very good care of yourself and never stop learning.